Now we're going to take a look at how we actually graph these things, because they're super fun to graph. I'll rewrite what we've got. We've got f of x, and we're a little bit smaller, is equal to negative x plus 1 for x less than 0, and x plus 2 for x is greater than or equal to 0. Number 1 and number 2. So I'm going to have me three graphs here. This first one is going to be just my number 1. This one's going to be just my number 2, and this one is going to be the combo. This is going to be my combo graph, okay? So for the first one, it's going to be y equals negative x plus 1, okay? That comes directly from here. F of x equals negative x plus 1, so y equals negative x plus 1. So we're just going to graph that one separately. So we've got a y-intercept of... We've got a y-intercept of 0, 1, and our slope, that's going to get in the way. Our slope is negative 1. So we've got a little point at 0, 1. Ah, come here. That's not what I meant. We've got a little point at 0, 1. Stop it. Okay, and since its slope is negative 1, we'll go down 1, over 1, down 1, over 1, and left 1, up 1, that kind of thing. So we've got our graph that looks basically like this. And we can try to be kind of careful when we do this. All right, now for our second one, we've got y equals x plus 2. And again, this x plus 2 refers directly to this x plus 2 right here. So we've got y-intercept is 0, 2, and our slope is positive 1. So we've got 0, 2, and then up 1, over 1. We go up like this, and down, yeah, like this. All right, that's a terrible line, but hopefully you get the point. All right, so this is where the funkiness comes in. What we need to do is look back at our conditions right here. And our conditions for the first one says, okay, this is valid when x is strictly less than 0, okay? So what we want to do is we want to go to our number 1 graph right here and say, okay, well, this is valid for everything, not including x equals 0, but everything to the left of it. So all this stuff over here counts, and that's what we care about. So we're just going to highlight, and we use this empty circle to mean we don't include the endpoint, but we want absolutely everything that is less than 0 because of this x is less than 0 thing here. Okay? For the second part, for the second one right here, we want everything where x is greater than or equal to 0. So we come over to our graph and we say equal to 0 is fine, and everything to the right of that. So we just go ahead and we color in the line that we did, but essentially the only thing we care about from this graph is wherever things are greater than or equal to 0. So remember, this is our x-axis. So anything from 0, which is right here, translates up to here. Anything over is good for us. So now the last step would be to combine these two graphs. So what I'm going to do is a little funky, but I'm going to circle this part, and I'm going to copy, make a copy so I can leave it there. Thank you. So see, I'm just taking this thing right here, and I'm going to move it down right to the exact same spot it was on before. Okay, so that's what I care about for this half. Now for the second half of the graph, this is what I care about. I care about everything that's over here. So I'll make a copy, and I'll paste. So this is the exact same thing right here. Good. And now I'm just going to pull it down right here. Okay. So actually, this is the graph that would be, quote, the answer. The answer to what this function up here looks like. If we were to graph this function, it would look like this. It tells us that if we wanted to know what, see, this is actually a little bit easier than what we did before by working it all out by hand, because everything's all written here. So if we had wanted to know, okay, well, what is f of 0? Well, it'd be pretty easy now because, you know, this means x equals 0, then y equals what? So we go over here and we say, okay, well, x is 0. What is y? What is my up and down value that's associated with that x equals 0? And we go, oh, okay, well, it's not this one because it's got that circle. That means I don't include it. So I keep going up and I go, oh my goodness, look, this is just beyond exciting for my little life. The thing that x is associated with is that 2. So I can read the x values from looking at this graph. So f of 0 is equal to 2. And that's in fact what we got whenever we worked it out before. So this is kind of how you look at these problems. Essentially, what you're going to do is you're going to graph each part of these separately, and then you're just going to highlight the parts that you care about, and then you're going to lay all those highlighted parts on top of each other and go from there. So I hope that was thrilling and exciting and hopefully helpful.